Hey everyone. So following on from my recent video about Gemini in Google Workspace, I wanted to explore this feature which I didn't get to test in that particular video called Smart Fill Suggestions, Enhanced Smart Fill Suggestions in Google Sheets, which uses AI to sort of fill in these columns and fill the gap in the platform at the moment. Because when you use Excel or Google Sheets and you want to fill a whole column, it can only really follow sort of simple patterns unless you use some formulas or other things. So basically what this is doing is using AI and the context to generate the content in the spreadsheet as well. I've been trying to test it out a few different examples. It's a bit weird, a bit finicky, and I think it's either still in experimentation or it's just has a limited use. But we can see here, this is the example they give on all the websites, web pages, where you've got the dates of these reviews, you have these specific reviews, and then you have the stars, a star rating, let's say. And you can tell that this one's 5-star because it's favorite hangout spot, this one's negative, this one's positive, this one's negative. And then once you get to here, if you fill this in, let's try it out now. It will try and help you. There we go. Once you press enter. So you need to have at least 3 rows or 3 data points that it can refer to. It doesn't do very well with numbers, with calculations, that kind of thing. It can do well like this, but not like formula sort of stuff. It's best with text and it really works with English, but I'm not sure it's very good with any other language at the moment. So let's have a look. We fill these rows. Food poisoning, 1-star. Awesome cocktails, 5-star. Bit pricey, but worth it for the night, 4-star. All right spot, 3-star. Scam overpriced, 1-star. Delicious, 5-star. Okay, great. So it looks like it's pretty accurate. So let's test some other examples as well. So I've got another one here set up for marketing taglines. And so what my goal here is to generate different marketing taglines based on, you know, what I've started to do here. I don't think there's enough information here. And so I've been testing it and saying, you know, product is amazing and fast, but then yeah, it's not going to give me anything else. So this isn't really working in terms of generation. Maybe if there was more context here, it would help. I've got this test for product codes. So we've got these product names here. We've got this category code here, and I've got this design of a product code here. So if we type in this code, should be SF. SADS001. Excellent. So I tested this before, so I'm glad it's still working. So we can see here, it's pulled the SF, it's pulled the TR, the SF, the TR, the TR, and then we've got the country, New Zealand, Australia, US, South Australia, New Zealand, and then we have the codes that stay the same. So this is quite useful if you're generating a more complex kind of code that's not just numerical. Okay, let's have a look at the next test here. So this one, I feel it's a bit more complicated, but for a human eye, it's very easy. We want to just pull out the phone numbers from these messages here. So they're all kind of different formatting, different order. Sometimes the numbers at the end, sometimes in the middle. And I've done 3 to start with. Okay, let's go back a step. Let me delete that one. Let me add this one in. So we go 999, 232, 234. Enter. Fill 4 rows. There we go. Let's fill those. And we can see the number, the number, the number, the number. This one's great. So that works very well. Now I've got this one here, these people, these cities, and then I'm hoping for it to help me with the country. Let's see. Germany. And it doesn't look like this one, it's able to work out this one. Let me try this instead. And we'll type in Germany again. It doesn't look like it can work this out. So you can see it's kind of a hit and miss. Maybe I've got something wrong here or something. I'm not sure what I'm missing here, but it's not helping me with this particular one. Okay. Now, when I was doing some research on this, I asked Gemini actually to help me. And And although this isn't actually true, and I've tried a lot of these things, Gemini suggested that it can help with filling in sequences. This is in the with the smart fill suggestions. Filling in sequences, days of the week, months of the year, abbreviations, product codes. Some of these you can do pretty easily in Sheets and Excel anyway. Data extraction, you can pull out first name, email domains. I'm pretty sure it could do that, just like the phone numbers. I think that's quite a good use. Creative text generation, so that the sentiment analysis, the ratings, you know, 5 stars or whatever, that seems pretty good. But then some of these other ones like marketing taglines, story prompts, it doesn't really seem to deliver on that at the moment. And I asked ChatGPT, what are the exact same question, what are some examples of how I can use smart fill suggestions in Google Sheets with Gemini? And ChatGPT was quite helpful, but also assumed that Gemini is the astrological sign. And so it gave me all these great ideas for using zodiac signs, searching with zodiac signs and things with the astrological sign for Gemini. So it looks like ChatGPT hasn't been informed of its competitor yet. So that's a bit of a shame for ChatGPT. But interestingly, it does still have a shot at creating these, you know, smart fill suggestions. So we've got, you have a list of birth dates in one column and then automatically fill in the adjacent column with the corresponding zodiac signs. Okay. So I thought I'd try that. It's an interesting idea. And so I've got the person's name, birthday, and then zodiac. Now, I might be getting the zodiacs wrong, so maybe this is why. But tell me if you notice anything that's wrong here. Pisces, Aquarius, Pisces. And then it should then complete the rest of these. But it doesn't seem to be. So, who knows? You let me know if you notice something maybe I've added in the data wrong. Or maybe it's just not, doesn't have all these features yet. But I think overall this is a nice little improvement to Google Sheets and a little bit of a implementation of AI. You can actually turn this on and off by going to Tools, Autocomplete, Enhance Smart Fill Suggestion, if you need to. If you need to turn it off, once you already have, you know, the subscription for Gemini, which I covered in the previous video, the earlier video that I did. So let me know if you've had a chance to try this, what you think of it. If you've worked out where I've gone wrong, please let me know. Or if you've got some other good examples of how you use this, I'd love to hear that as well. Drop it down in the comments. If this is useful for you, you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe. If you like this video, like it. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers.